Hello, how is everyone? I'm Anushka Sisodia, 6th year medical student studying in Ukraine. It's been some time since I filmed a video where I've just been sitting and speaking because I've made a lot of videos where I've been outside. So I thought I'll just make a video this time where I'm just speaking something, obviously, which will be of use to you. Some time ago, I made a video where I was talking about how I used Notion to make a revision schedule for my revision. I got a lot of questions about that video and a lot of people asked me to make a video where I explain in detail how I use this app Notion to make a revision schedule for myself. If you haven't seen that shorts, I'll put the link to that in the description box below and you can see it for yourself. Also, in the end of this video, I'll give you guys my review of how helpful this table was to myself while I was trying to revise my gynecology. So a little bit of how I came to this like app and how I tried to make a like table for myself which will help me for revision, because I've been trying to study for some time for my FMG and next examination whichever I will give in some months. So I was really, really confused because I did not know how to revise and I felt like quite a burden because I have already done some of the subjects and I couldn't find the time to revise the subject because you like obviously delay that, yeah, you will do revise the subject when you have completed the subject, and it becomes really a lot to revise because I cannot find the time to revise all of it. If you're a medical student, I am sure you understand how important it is to revise your topics, how important it is to do the MCQs and everything. You must have googled things like how to make a revision schedule and how to revise your subject properly and how you can learn facts for longer. If you didn't, you wouldn't be here and watching this video. I'm glad you're here and I hope I can provide you with some information and I can help you guys. I'm not sure if you've heard words like active recall and spaced repetition because they're kind of really important if you want to learn more facts and if you want to remember things for longer. We have always used these methods to remember different stuff in our lives, but some person just happened to have named them as active recall and spaced repetition, so they might seem new to you, but these are the things that you've always done to remember things. This time what I have tried to do is that I've tried to make a table out in the Notion app. So I have tried to make a table which will actually remind me when I have to revise and what I have to revise. What I wanted was that something to remind me that I have to revise this topic at this moment. There are apps like Anki which does the same, but I don't like Anki as such. I have used it, but the thing with that is that I feel like whenever I'm revising, I need to like revise everything all together so that I don't miss anything. I just don't like to remember some segments of it. I like to revise it on a whole. This method is not my original. Before like making this specific table, I watched a lot of videos from a lot of different people. This is the table that I found was really like something that I could customize to myself and something that has really helped me for some past few months. So yeah, that's why I actually liked it. So why am I using Notion? Notion app is, it has endless of pages and it can be fully customized according to your need. It is free to use if you're using for one person. Like you can also use it for your office settings and everything, like multiple people can connect and you can share your data online, but obviously I'm using just for myself, so it's free to use. And also it like all the data is stored online and you can use this app on all of your devices. So I will just share my screen. So I will show you guys how I've used this and I'll try to explain to you in the most easy way I possibly can. And even after my explanation, if you have any doubt, then you can let me know in the comment section or you can contact me via Gmail or Instagram. Both of those are given in the description box below. So you can see I've named my table PrepLadder Revision because I'm using PrepLadder for studying for FMG and next. I watched the videos. As you can see, I have made some changes. If you have seen the shorts, you will see there are some changes. For example, in topics section, I have put the names of the videos because that, like when I was discussing with my friends, when I was sharing this table with my friends, I found out that it's easy if I like just for every video I make a different section, so that way it will be more easier for me to know like at like which topic I have to revise on which day. So what I meant when I said that it has endless of pages, like if you will put anything under this double A kind of thing, you will see there's an underline, so you can open this into a new page and under this page you can put anything and all the information you want. And in this also you can make more pages and more pages and more pages. So that's what I meant when I said that it has endless of pages, like you can include any information wherever you want. Just remember that if you want to put information for a certain topic, then always put that into this double A kind of thing. That way it will show underline and you can open it to a page, because that is something you won't see in any other columns. So that is, my table is quite big. I will just show you. I have done all of my gynecology and obstetrics. I have completed it finally and it was a lot. And it took me some time because I was also revising. You will see that this R1, R2, R3, R4, I5, R6 are the revisions. That too, this revision schedule I took from Dr. Abbas Ali. And I will explain everything. I'll just show you how big it is actually for all. And then recently I've started with medicine. It's a lot. I will just filter out some things so it will become easy. For example, I'll put a filter where completed on exact date, that is 30th of July. Okay, so yeah, the table is reduced, so it will make it a lot easier for me to scroll, because as far as I've used Notion, there is only one way you can go from left to right if you're using it in a laptop. That is, you have to use the scroller, and that only comes at the end of the table. So yeah, I reduced the table only so that I could scroll it here and here, so it's easy for me to explain it to you guys. I made a list of the topics which I can put in this first section. The days. Days means for my revision, when I've actually completed all of the revision of this subject, when I will be doing a quick revision or a rapid revision, that time I put this days because I want to revise all of this topic on the same day. If you don't want, you can remove this column completely. Next is the subject. So right now I've only done two subjects. For example, there is obstetrics and gynecology, which I've done, and I started with medicine because one topic can belong to multiple subjects. So that's why which topic I have done from which subject, that's why I have put this subject column over here. Completed means the day I did the topic. I did all of these topics in July. And these are the revisions which I have done. I have done by far now 5 revisions of all of these topics. I remember a lot of it and I am proud of myself for actually completing all of this revision, not on the exact day, but a day plus or two. So I was glad that I have been able to do it. And then the next in this table, the most important part is this next review column. In this column, you have put this formula. Means I have put this formula. Obviously, this formula I have copied and customized it according to how I need it. For example, according to this schedule, which says that your first revision should be on the next day. Like if I have studied something today, I need to revise it tomorrow. So the next revision should be after 2 days. So what I did was I added plus 2 in the first day. So that meant 3 days. So from the day I have completed, it will be 3 days after which I have to do the revision again. The next was after 7 days. So 7 days plus the 3 days which I have actually done. So it meant 10 days later I have to again do the third revision. Fourth revision is after 2 weeks. So 10 plus 14, it's 24. So that's how I calculated. And then there is 1 month, so 24 plus 30, 54. And then there is 2 months, so 54 plus 60, 114. So yeah, that's how I did it. What I actually wanted to do is that I couldn't put just 7, 14, 30 and 60, because that would have meant that I am like, because it's a formula. So if I just put 10, 7, it will just add those days into this section of completed. So that's why I couldn't do it, and that would have reduced the revision, and that would have actually compiled a lot of information in a very small amount of time. So I wanted my revision to be like after a certain period of time. That's why I added these days. In the notification columns, I always do it manually. So how I make notifications for myself, I will show you in this medicine section, which I have done. So I have divided by subject. And these are the topics. So I put the notifications. So you will see if I do any of these subjects. I have done 4 revisions by far of this topic, which is named medical illnesses complicating the pregnancy. If I put a tick over here, which means that I have completed the 5th revision. So if I come, like you will see that next review date right now is 8th of October because today I have to do revision. So if I complete the revision today, that is October 8th, 2021, if I put a check over here, means I've completed the revision 5th, and that will show me the date of December 7th, that is almost 2 months from now. Like right now it's October 8, 2021. So if I put the tick over here, means I have completed the revision. So I manually go over here in the notification section and I put the date, which is December 8th. You have to select the date and then you have to put a reminder when you want to get yourself a reminder, like on the day of event or 1 day before, 2 days before, whenever. So I always put the reminder on the day of event. So I know that on this day only I have to revise. If I put anything over here, then it doesn't change anything because that just means that I have completed the 6th revision, and after that maybe I will extend the formula when I've completed all of like the subject at once. So right now I'm not extending the formula, otherwise the table will just go on and on and on. There's an option of adding a view where you can add all of these views. So this is default view, means I can see all of the things that I have put in my table. So today is I have put a filter. You will see that filter where I have put that notification is today. So all of the places where the notification will be today's date, for example, all of these dates are like notifications are today's. So I got all of these notifications for today that I have to revise all of these topics, and they are red because they are today's date. So if I open this page up, you will see that the next revision date has changed. You can also, like, if you don't want to scroll all the way across right from left, you can open a page, and if you will put this page into this table, you can see all of these details like in this way. So I can again change it because I haven't done the revision, so I know it's today. So I will put the date again back, that is October 8th. You have to click on it, then only it will be selected, otherwise it won't be selected. You have to click on it and then you have to just, you can go outside and you will see that it's today's date. So what I do these days is that I have prioritized my revisions, and that's why I don't do any new videos until unless I have done all the revisions, because this is only as much customizable. Like if you have missed today, but if you put a check mark tomorrow, still the date will be same only. Like if I don't do the revision today and if I put the checkbox tomorrow, then still the date will be like what according to formula. It is not that customizable, or it is not like it's a formula. So that's why I have prioritized my revision and I try to do my revision as much as possible today only, or at max by the next day. Like I will try to postpone it only till tomorrow, otherwise later than that I will not try to postpone it, and I will do all of the revisions and then only I will start watching new videos. Obviously I know it's a lot. Notion app in itself is a lot, but if you really understand the basics and if you really try to do this, if you actually want, I'm willing to help you guys all in making this revision, because I've actually helped my friend. He also wanted to make this table, so I actually helped him. So if you want, I will show you guys again how to make a revision schedule, like how you can make this table step by step. If you want this, then let me know in the comment section below and I'll make a video again about this topic, because I really feel like this has helped me a lot, and if anyone else can also benefit from this, then why not. I want to show something else as well. These are the missed notifications which I haven't done today. So here what I've done is that in the filter section I have put the notification again is before today, because if I have missed it, then all these things will be here and I know that I have missed these, and I really need to do this by today only. Then another one is first revisions, is because I haven't done even a single revision of these videos. These are something that I have studied yesterday, so I didn't do anything. So in this filter what I have added is that R1, the first revision, is unchecked, and that's how I see that I haven't done any of the like revision. So I have to do revision for these topics as well today. So yeah, that's all I guess. It's a lot, I understand, but it might seem a lot right now, but it will help a lot in the future, because I always felt like I haven't revised anything at all, and I'm really very happy that I have revised this much. It has helped me a lot in learning things, and I really love this Notion app. for as long as I've used it. If you have any queries or feedback, then you can leave them in the comment section below and I would love to hear from you. Well, thank you so much for watching this video. If you watched this video till now, then I am really, really glad that you could be a part of it. And if you found this video helpful in any way, then give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos. And I will see you guys soon in another video. Until then, bye, take care and have a good day.